what's even cuter than pigs? Micro pigs. Yep, that's right. Scientists in China have genetically engineered pigs to grow to only about 30 pounds. While originally engineered for biomedical research, they are so adorable that the company who made them is actually going to start selling them as pets for a mere $1,600 each. After these little piggies go to market, you might one day even be able to custom order them by selecting different coat colors that scientists can set through genetic modifications. And guess what? These micro pigs aren't the only genetically engineered animals you can get as pets. You can also buy glow-in-the-dark fish. To be clear, when I say genetically engineered, I don't mean your designer dogs bred through selective breeding. No, I mean an animal whose DNA has been altered through human technology. So like cutting and splicing genes, some real fancy biotech stuff. You know, animals have been genetically engineered for all sorts of reasons. For example, there's mice that are engineered to have different diseases for medical research and drug development. Salmon have been engineered to grow super fast so that we can farm them quicker. And then there's consumer products, like those cute little pigs. But genetic engineering isn't met without controversy. People have varying views on what's ethically acceptable when it comes to messing with an animal's DNA. For example, some people think that genetically engineering animals to make cool pets is just a frivolous use of a powerful technology. In fact, California actually cited this reason when they banned the sale of those glow-in-the-dark pet fish, which, by the way, were originally created to be a kind of live pollution detector and glow in the presence of pollution. People are also concerned about animal welfare. Changing even a small bit of DNA can lead to unforeseen consequences, things like increased susceptibility to disease, changes in behavior, or even physical abnormalities. And to make a new genetically engineered animal can involve some invasive procedures or a large number of embryos, which makes some people uneasy. People also worry about potential negative environmental consequences. If genetically engineered animals get out into the wild, could they outcompete or interbreed with native species? And then there are philosophical objections based on the view that animals just shouldn't be used or exploited for human gain, or the idea that we shouldn't be messing with the genes of any animal, period. Others are more willing to accept genetically engineered pets and view the process more like an extension of selective breeding, which we've been doing for a long time. Like how we've been breeding cows to produce more milk or racehorses to be super fast, and of course, those designer dogs. Some may think it's okay to have a GMO pet as long as the pet was originally created for biomedical purposes. Or people might think that GM pets are fine depending on the type of animal. Like someone might be cool having a genetically engineered fish or reptile, but may have some more reservations about genetically engineered mammals. So, as genetically engineered animals and pets become increasingly common, would you buy one? What are the most important ethical considerations for you? What kind of regulations, if any, should be put in place? We want you to tell us what you think. Read the blog post, check out our additional resources, do some of your own research, and share your thoughts with people around the country. Tweet us at KQED EdSpace using hashtag DoNowGMOPets. Thanks!